is meant for an adult audience. LoveLine may contain sexually oriented content. Listener discretion is advised.
LoveLine with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
Hey, everybody, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam, that's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Dr. Drew, board-certified physician, addiction medicine specialist. Dr. Drew is in Syracuse, New York tonight, yes?
I sure am.
Mm-hmm.
It's good times.
Yeah, you know, I used to say yes and sort of have my tongue in my cheek, but now I realize I'm doing it intentionally.
What's that?
Saying yes.
Yeah, it's a nice brisk 32 degrees.
Yes.
A couple feet of snow on the ground.
Yes.
Yes. Weather, fog, and goddamn it took me like 14 hours to get here because of the fog in Chicago.
Yes. Well, Drew only does gigs that involve 3 or 4 flights and a mule. Idiot. Okay. Yeah, there you go. Drew, seriously, what time did you leave L.A. this morning?
Let's see. It's 1 a.m. Eastern time at 10 a.m. At 5:30.
5:30 you left your house.
Yeah. No.
What?
I think I left the terminal at 6 o'clock. I was at the airport at 5:30.
Really? But the flight doesn't leave till 7, does it?
No, it was 6. It was like 6 o'clock, 6:15. I sat on the tarmac for 3 hours. Don't worry.
Of course. All to go pick up a nickel in Syracuse. What a strategy.
Yeah.
No, nothing direct to Syracuse either, right?
Yeah, just
got to fly to Chicago. Just one fogged in flight to Chicago.
That's right.
Fantastic. All right, buddy. Enjoy.
All right.
When are you coming home?
Tomorrow.
Jesus Christ, you're such an idiot. What are you thinking? All right, anyway.
I'm seeing the world. Seeing the country.
Seeing the world. That's right.
Listen, you know what, Adam? I was at Syracuse University, and I was in the room that you and I spoke in many years ago. Remember that?
Yeah. Yeah. And, that was the old Adam.
Yeah. Adam used to go around, travel with me, and gave a crap about people and kids and wanted to talk to them.
That's right.
What happened?
That was the old Adam and do anything for a nickel. Now I got a couple of bucks. Screw those kids in Syracuse. Okay, here's the point. First off, Puddle of Mudd is coming on the show tonight, or are coming on the show tonight. Wesley is going to be here, lead singer from Puddle of Mudd. I don't know where he is, so he'll be here. And classic now Chris has picked up the phone. He's distracting me. What's going on over there, Chris? 10 minutes. Okay, I figured that had something to do with us. Wow, this is a first, Drew. Someone's late for the show.
Oh, never.
We got to push it back to 10:30. Here's the point. He's coming in here from Puddle of Mudd. That's good. They've sold, you know, their last album sold 5 million copies.
Wow.
Yeah, you know, Puddle of Mudd, like we were doing this with Linkin Park a few days ago. Like, you think of Linkin Park as, those guys, nice guys. What do? They sold 8 million records. You know what I mean?
I know. It's incredible.
Puddle of Mudd, you'd be like, this guy, what are they doing? Playing? Proms and stuff like that. They're making a living, aren't they? I mean, they travel in the van, but they're out of their parents' house, aren't they? Yeah. 5 million records. True. We got to get hip to the scene. You understand?
Yeah.
Because I know you. I asked
Drew
the other. I asked him what he thought the biggest seller of 2002 was. He said Burt Bacharach. Is that true, Drew?
No.
No.
I thought I said Barbra Streisand.
I think it may have been Brazil 66.
Okay.
All right, we got to move forward here.
All right.
Guess who was over at the Ozman's house today, Drew?
Who?
Me.
Wow, nice.
While you're chasing a nickel in Syracuse, I'm chilling with the Ozman over
what
at the
happened?
Osborne Estate. MTV was doing some kind of something or other over there, some kind of Christmas extravaganza, and they wanted me to come over and do a little something-something. So I came over and did a little something-something. You know, the thing about, I've seen the Osbournes 1,000 times on TV. It's a great show. I enjoy it. I love everybody. But the house is really impressive in real life.
I bet.
I mean, it's a substantial house.
Yeah.
You want to know, let me tell you, Drew. Let me tell you how you know it's a serious, serious house. When the hardware is custom made. I'm talking about the hinges, the handles.
Really?
You know what I mean?
Really?
You think... Drew, in your penny ante life, you wouldn't think anything could get better than just the best hardware.
Right.
Like, if you're willing to step up to the Baldwin, that the Baldwin polished brass, that's the best money can buy. That's the best life has to offer. But you don't realize that when people who have super mega bucks build a house, they forge their own hardware.
That's incredible. I didn't know it was such a thing.
All Ozzy's locks have like the cross on it, and the hinges for the front doors are two wrists clenched in a fist holding the hinge pins, you know, the size of real hands, made of solid brass sticking out. Like, it's like, you know, normally you just want to sort of ignore, you know, you hope you don't see the hinges. When you go to a really nice house, there's thousands and thousands of dollars just of the hardware, just of the decoration stuff out there. Oh, yeah. Ooh. Very nice. Nice kitchen.
I just didn't know. You don't even think about those options. Didn't really know they existed. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. When you're doing the big stuff, you got like your initials and stuff forged into all the doorknobs. That's what big bucks is. All right, Drew. Ready to rock?
Yeah.
Yeah, anyway, he had had snow put down there, and it was nice. Yeah, got a little snow around. I think they
What exactly were you doing there?
I just did a little bit. You know what? I was telling people how to make cranberry sauce. You know how I like cranberries?
Yeah, you drive us crazy with it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Fresh cranberries?
Yes, yes.
That's what I was doing over there.
That's good.
All right. And let me just say one thing real fast about the Oz House and anybody involved with any kind of city planning or anything. I know this is something I brought up before, but naturally I got the horrible directions, you know.
Yeah.
Directions said, you know, take Sunset down to Doheny and then take Doheny down to this way, right?
Yeah.
Well, there's Doheny. And then there's Doheny Road, and then there's Doheny Place, and then there's Doheny Canyon. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, yes.
And which street, which Doheny do you turn on? I'll tell you which one. The first goddamn Doheny you see. When you're driving along a main road and you're like looking for a street, and you see that street, you turn on it. And then the one that says Canyon is the next block, but it's too late. You've turned on the first one. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes.
Drew, do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, I see what you're saying.
Yes.
Yes. Well,
what kind of retarded logic is it to name three goddamn streets the same name and put them in the same effing place?
I know. Look, then there's North and South as though they're entirely different streets. Yeah.
Yes. Wesley's here from Puddle of Mudd.
What's up, everybody?
He's angry, too, about this thing.
Sorry I'm late. Yeah, I'm late.
It's
actually,
all right.
I am upset.
We don't care. We're fine. We're glad that you're here now. That's what
Thanks,
I'm saying.
Adam.
But I'm saying, why name a street the same name three times and then give it the place, the road, and the way? You know what I'm saying?
Ego.
It's very confusing. I turned down Doheny and drove all the way down to Wilshire before I realized I was heading in the wrong direction and made it back up to the Osborne place in one piece. Still had to wait around for an hour.
Did you have a good time, man?
Oh, yeah. You ever been to the Osborne place?
Never.
It's cool.
Cool.
It's like the TV show, but but it smells weird. And Ozzy ain't moving around like Peter Pan anymore. He's slowed down a little bit, the Oz man has.
Yeah.
I'm not sure, Drew. You probably, by the way, every third person I ran into in the Osborne house pulled me aside and said, tell Drew I'm doing good, thanks. So, evidently, a lot of drugs going around in that place.
They're doing great.
They're doing great?
Yeah.
All right. Let's talk about Puddle of Mudd for just one good second.
Is that
here.
Drew?
Yeah, that's Drew.
Hey, man, what's up?
How are you?
Nice talking to you, brother.
Yeah. Haven't seen you guys in a long time.
Well, you're not going to see him tonight either because you're in Syracuse trying to make a buck instead of doing your job out here.
Relax.
You're the man. You are the man.
You like Drew, really?
Yeah.
He's all right. You guys can come, but you know, I'm here. That's important.
He's a doctor, man. He's got good knowledge.
Yeah, people think that, but wait till you see. He's not that impressive in real life. it's like a chick you always thought was hot, and then you see her in real life. She's kind of short, and she's got thick ankles. That's Drew with the knowledge.
Oh, okay.
You see what I'm saying? You think he's smart, then you see him, and it's kind of,
We should all go swimming with bow-legged women, too. So.
Hey, Drew.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, buddy. Just checking with you. All right. Now, don't fade off on me because I know it's like a 1:30 where you are right now, right?
It's 1:30, and I'm just like a punching bag here, taking abuse from you, right? What do you want me to do? Jump in and
take a chill. Take a chill pill, brother. I'm gonna talk about Puddle of Mudd. Just quiet down.
Adam, you sound high to me.
No, I'm not.
You're drunk.
No, I'm not. How dare you? I had a glass of champagne over the one glass. One glass. That was many hours ago.
Yeah. He's got like a bottle of Dom right here, man.
Wesley's had a few nips, so I can smell that on him. Nothing wrong with that. It's part of the rock style. It's part of the lifestyle. All right, so the new CD comes out Tuesday, tomorrow, right?
Yes, man.
The 25th. We're going to hear something off the new CD. It's called Life on Display. I was, I don't know if you heard me talking about it, but I can't believe that 5 million copies of Come Clean were sold in 2001. It's amazing.
It is, man. It's amazing.
Yeah? You still surprised?
It's a crazy experience, you know, but you got to move on and you know, write more songs, so.
Yeah, do you feel pressure because the first CD was so successful?
It's a factor, but you know, I'm trying not to look at it like that. I'm just writing music.
Good. You're keeping it real. That's what we call it, Drew. Hey, by the way, the band, are you guys from San Diego?
No.
Because the band played a free show to raise money for the fire victims in San Diego.
Yes.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, it's nice. I thought you only do that for your hometown kind of
thing. Right.
Well, there wasn't really a fire there.
Your hometown?
Well, there wasn't, you know.
Where is your hometown?
Kansas City.
You got to start a fire over there.
It's a little hard. I mean, there's a lot of clouds and rain and
snow.
Well,
do something. Maybe a race ride or something. Whatever it is. then Puddle of Mudd comes in and heals the city. That's what I'm talking about. All right. We're going to take some calls. Drew, you ready to take some calls?
Yeah, I'd love to do that, Adam.
Let me tell you what a science this show is. You know, last night you put your Post-it sticker next to the call you wanted last at the end of last night's show.
It's still there.
It's still there. So guess which call we're starting with.
We're going for the one I picked out last night.
Right. You remember what line that was?
Six?
No.
Five?
No.
Then I don't remember.
Keep going.
Two?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got a gift, buddy.
That's what I'm talking about.
Rebecca. All right, calm down now. Rebecca?
Hello?
You're 20. What's up?
Yeah, hey, Dr. Drew, hey, Adam. Just wanted to say how big of a fan I am. I've been listening to you guys since I was, like, 14.
Great.
I think you guys are so wonderful. Okay, so I have two questions.
Mm-hmm.
First question is regarding my fiancé, and he's kind of into necrophilia.
Who?
Well, no.
He just dabbles in it, just wets his beak in it. It's not a full-time thing.
He likes for me to lay down and pretend that I'm dead and not move. And at first it was a joke because, you know, we just thought it was cute. And now he's asking me to do it on a regular basis, and it's really freaking me out. And I don't know how to deal with it in an appropriate manner because I don't want to make him self-conscious.
I wonder if he's calling it lay down and pretend you're dead when the reality is he just wants you to lie down and be still. You know what I'm saying, Adam? You know what I mean? The guys may have screwed up ways of getting their sort of needs met. And like, let's play a game. Let's pretend you're dead. Mm-hmm. And in reality, guys just like, I need you to hold still.
No. But I really try and fulfill his sexual prowess.
Well, how do you do that when you can't move?
Well, I mean, in other ways, like in an oral fashion or something else.
Well, I know, but like during the necrophilia portion of the sexual ride, you have to lie motionless, right?
Right.
And so you can't really do much for him, right?
Uh-huh.
You see, that may be the only way he can get her to do that.
No, I don't know, but does he... Wait a minute. Does he say necrophilia?
Yeah, he said we're going to play necrophiliac.
And does he talk about...
Yeah.
But is he talking about those things? Is he into death and death images? And
no.
Does he talk...
It's not gothy?
No, not at all. No.
He doesn't talk about dying people or interested in that?
No, he's totally normal.
And what does he ask?
I was just going to say, the next game that he's probably going to make you play is like maybe jumping on a trampoline like naked or something.
Hey, that's a great idea. That's genius.
He wants me to lie there and be still. I don't know.
See, I think, I really think he's just, this is the way he gets her to lie still.
I know.
Because she's so busy. She's so busy satisfying him. He can't get her to relax, just be still, and let him do his thing. You know what I'm saying?
Drew, you have a lot of harebrained schemes. I'm on board with most of them, but I don't think you risk creeping her out and freaking her out by saying this. Although, let's find out what he does when you pretend you're dead.
He just, you know, he makes me lie still and yeah. goes at it until he, you know, goes to orgasm and, you know, so, and then it's over.
So he has sex with you?
Yeah.
Okay, and you ever fake a dead orgasm?
No, I don't orgasm during sex.
That'd be nice, though. Just her dying breath was a fake orgasm.
But that's at least okay. how you can rationalize what women do with you, Adam.
Yeah. You know, I think I've had sex with some corpses before.
That's what I'm saying.
Not sure. All right, this is, I don't know about this guy. What's he do for a living?
He's a student. He's a senior in college.
What's he doing next year?
Are his parents alive? Did he see any death? Anything weird? Was he in NAM? Anything?
No. Both of his parents are.
Adam,
are
every single time she mentions necrophilia, she goes, "He just wants me to lie still." He doesn't want her sort of, draped in a in a shroud. He just wants her to lie still, and he calls that "Let's play necrophilia."
Yeah. Drew, I think you're chasing your retarded tail.
I have another question.
Yeah.
I was diagnosed with polycystic ovarian syndrome when I was 16.
Aha.
Yeah.
And my doctor last year suggested that I go on glucophage, which is a medication that makes you super fertile. And I got
No. Glucophage is for diabetes.
Right, but it's used to treat women with polycystic ovarian syndrome because we can't deal with insulin properly.
Right. It has nothing to do with the ovarian function or with fertility. It just helps you with your insulin resistance.
Okay.
Theoretically, it may even decrease your risk of developing diabetes, but it certainly helps you, your sugar metabolism just generally.
Okay. My doctor had told me that we don't put women on this unless we're trying to actively get them to have a baby, and I got engaged to him in December, and I'm getting a lot of flack from my family because they all want me to go on it so I don't damage my system any further than it already has been by this disease. So I'm wondering if I should go on it and risk having a baby.
What, Drew?
Wait a minute. You got this all screwed up. First of all, your system has not been damaged by polycystic ovarian disease, okay?
Okay.
Are you overweight?
No.
Okay. You may not even have the insulin resistance if you're not overweight associated with polycystic ovarian disease. But as a sort of a safety, many particularly gynecologists, were advised patients to go on glucophage to help with the insulin metabolism.
Hold on a second, Drew. Wait, let me just say one thing. Yeah. Everybody, you can't ask a crazy necrophilia question that's going to last 4 minutes and then follow it up with a polycystic ovarian question. Yeah. You got one goddamn question.
Yeah. No, just that, to say, she's got it all screwed up.
I don't care. We're on minute six of her thing.
But the reason to treat the diabetes is they get gestational diabetes. They get diabetes during the pregnancy. If they get pregnant, the glucophage really, to my knowledge, does not affect fertility per se. So don't worry about that.
All right. Rebecca's a little nutty.
Yeah.
A little angry too. Something's going on with her.
Just energy.
Whew. Maybe her boyfriend's just tired of hearing her yap all
That's
the time.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm talking about.
I'm agreeing with Drew. Just baby. Yeah. But see, I try that pretend you're dead stuff when we're watching TV with my wife. It's necrophiliac time, except there'll be no sex. We're just daddy's gonna watch TV in peace now. You pretend like you're a rotting corpse. And give me the TiVo remote. Yeah? Wesley, ever do that? Do that with the old lady?
Negative, Ghost Rider.
No, don't do that. All right. Drew, you ought to try that with your wife. Yeah?
No. Remember, wife's the...
Your wife what?
It's the beer waiting for me at home after I've toured the beer factory. I liked that last night. Remember that?
Is that what I said about your wife?
No, you said I couldn't go to a strip bar because it'd be like you going to a beer factory. And I said, and I've got my favorite beer waiting for me at home.
Yeah. I was like me going, you can't go to a strip club because it'd be like me going to a beer factory not getting to sample the beer.
Right.
And
your favorite beer is, in my case, my favorite beer is waiting for me at home.
Right. You like that bad domestic stuff in a can, you see. I like the European stuff. That's me. Michael?
Yeah?
You're 14?
Yep.
What's up there, pre-pube?
Never mind. Never mind. I'm having troubles ejaculating, pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
How old are you?
14.
Have you ever ejaculated?
Once.
Once? Okay. In your sleep, right?
No.
No? You were awake?
Yeah.
And what'd you do? How'd you get it to do that?
The good old-fashioned hand.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. All right. But not again?
Yeah, I've been trying and...
Sure.
Like, almost nothing would come out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Almost nothing?
Like, yeah. Almost nothing. Like, drip. Not barely a drip.
Yeah, well, get used to it. That's about it. You've been watching those movies on the internet.
No, I haven't.
You haven't?
No.
Why aren't you watching those movies on the internet?
Because I'm not a bad boy.
Wow. You don't sound like a bad boy, but you sure sound like a weird boy. Yeah, all right, buddy. Well, look, Drew, what happens? This is getting weird for me, but what happens when a young 14-year-old, he gets one, he squeezes one off, but there's no repeat performance.
Yeah, it's sort of like women when they start their period. They have their period, then it's really irregular, and it doesn't come for a while, and then it kicks in.
Right.
It's not it's not the accelerator being pushed to the floor immediately. It takes a while.
So you might be able to get one off. I don't know what, I'm trying to figure out my whacking chronology here, but... I think I squeezed one off somewhere at 16, late bloomer.
Wow.
And then thought, well, all right, this is the kind of thing I could do two, maybe three times a year. Little did I know. Do you know what I'm saying? Little did I know it would become a career. I had no idea. I was like, wow, that's good. Let's see. What are we, in April? I'll be planning for a November jack. But I didn't know it would work out the way it did. I didn't know my penis and my hand would fall in love. That's the thing.
Just give it time, man. Just give it time.
Yeah, he's got to
Jack Fest.
Yeah, he's got to. Michael's just got to. Don't pressure yourself.
Yeah,
an angry hand and a confused penis are a bad combination. Yes, Drew?
Yes, bad. Bad combination.
Thank
bad.
You. Okay. Bad. Good. You just repeat the last two words I say. Yes,
that's what I am to do. Yes.
Yes. See, sometimes you can just do the last word. Yes.
Yes.
Okay?
Okay.
Good.
Good.
Okay, stop.
I'll stop.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Okay, quiet. All right, Wes is here from Puddle of Mudd. We're going to hear something off the new CD, which is coming out tomorrow, and then I'm going to tell you guys how you can win a CD.
Tomorrow.
It's coming out tomorrow, isn't it?
November 25th.
Oh, November 25th. What the hell are we? Oh, what's it?
You've been hanging out at Aussies too long, man.
Oh, my God. Hey, let me ask you this, Drew. In the kitchen, a giant novelty-sized mortar and pestle.
Ooh.
Isn't that bad for a drug addict family to have that huge pharmacist drug-crushing thing?
Yeah, maybe they use it for food.
Don't worry, I got it out of there.
Oh, good.
I got it out of there. That's good. November 25th, which is... what are we on? What are we in?
It's November 25th on a Tuesday. It's called Life on Display.
That's a week from tomorrow.
That would be correct.
I'm going to write that out. I'm going to write that down. Yeah. That's 1 week from tomorrow, kiddies. Drew's out in Syracuse, and we'll hear something off the new CD after this.
Hello. This is your radio. LoveLine will be right back.
Every hour, two Americans under the age of 25 are infected with HIV. Protect yourself. Call toll-free 1-866-344-KNOW.
Hey, everybody, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew.
Hey, Adam.
Drew's in Syracuse. Quiet down, Drew.
Yeah,
Drew's in Syracuse tonight, by the way. 1-800-LOVE-191. Wesley's here from Puddle of Mudd. We're going to hear
what's up
off the new CD, which is coming out 1 week from tomorrow on the 25th. Life on Display is the name of the CD. Yes, Drew.
And we had that caller from, with polycystic ovarian disease a few minutes ago, and I looked up what she was talking about, the glucophage and its effect on fertility. And the glucophage is to affect the insulin resistance associated with this disorder. Sure. And in about 30% of cases, it might, add in glucophage and losing weight, can add to the resumption of ovulation about 30% of cases. Mm-hmm. So it means she still will have much lower fertility than average and will need to take the birth control pill, but it doesn't make
boring.
Her super... Well, she was saying, I'm going on glucophage. I'm going to get pregnant right away. It's nothing like that.
Wesley told me this whole thing during the break, except for Wesley, he did say between 31 and 33%, not 30%. I don't want to make you look stupid on the radio, but Wesley kind of explains the whole glucophage thing to me and how it affects fertility during the break. All right.
There you go.
So I'm up to speed. All right. Well, good times there, Drew.
Yeah, good times.
Now, slap that laptop closed on your nutsack, would you?
All right.
Here you go. Please. This computer, you know, everyone thinks it's a great breakthrough. Meanwhile, you got everyone looking everything up and boring everybody. All right. Looking good, though, Drew. Looking real good.
Good
hey,
time.
Yeah. Later on Wednesday, Pink is coming in here, and then Kathy Griffin's coming in here, and Rob Schneider's coming in here, and Blink-182's coming in, Ron Livingston's coming in here, and then a band called Thanksgiving Off. Oh, ooh. No, wait a minute, Drew. That's our favorite band, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
That's right. That's
love
Thanksgiving,
there.
Baby doll.
Yeah.
All right, we got that to look forward to. All right, so where were we? We'll take a call. Let's do a Germany or Florida.
Okay.
And then we'll play a song from Puddle of Mudd.
Germany,
oh, here's the theme.
Or Florida.
Here's how the game goes, Wesley.
Oh, good idea.
We've decided that the universe of evil is split between Germany and Florida. All bizarre evil comes out. Now, not just killing your kids evil, but sort of bizarre, twisted evil. It either comes out of Germany or Florida. So people call in, they give us a bizarre story, and we make a guess, Germany or Florida. John?
Hey.
What's up?
What's up?
I just wanted to let you know, I created Germany or Florida online.
Mm-hmm.
So you can play the wonderful game online.
Thank you, John.
Thanks.
Florida or Germany.com?
Germany or Florida.com.
I beg your
Thank
pardon.
You for ripping off the idea that I ripped off from the Jimmy Kimmel Show, which never put it on the air. But go ahead. John? What happened to John? He dropped the phone?
I think you scared him.
He's Jesus got bad Christ. Service.
Mm. All right. I was expecting a good Germany or Florida from John because, after all, he had a website. Germanyorflorida.com. Jesus Christ. All right, now he's off the line. Now I really want to play Germany or Florida. So somebody call in. But screeners, listen carefully because I don't want to do one we've done before. Let's see. Parents constantly fight about divorce. No. Is it normal for girls to have wet dreams? Huh? That's Sarah from Chicago. Yeah, let's talk to Sarah. Sarah?
Hey, what's up, you guys?
You're 18.
Yeah.
You want to know if it's normal for girls to have wet dreams?
Yeah.
What about it, Drew?
Yeah,
seems women easier.
They may not even be wet necessarily. We're not.
Yeah, no, they're not wet. It's just like I get off, you know.
Yeah, that's a very normal thing. It's
okay,
a good thing.
Well,
it's a good thing.
I had another question. Is it normal for like girls to get tighter over time, like when they're sexually active?
Tighter?
Yeah, like I get tighter instead of
depending
like,
on the man.
Yeah, I'll bring a girl in a couple of notches. I'll ratchet that vagina in. My penis is like a key that opens a sardine can. You know, I get in there, I turn it a couple of cranks.
Gets tighter.
Tight, ratchets it right down. Yeah. Their eyes start opening wider. But the crotch gets smaller. Something's got to give. Drew, what about it? Can a constant pounding make the vagina contract?
No, I don't see how. It just may make it feel that way a little bit, but no, it shouldn't.
No, because it gets sore.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, because most people say that it loosens up, right?
Yeah.
All right. So, Sarah, you're fine. And it would be easier for a woman to have a wet dream than a guy because they don't have moving parts.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
I mean, a guy to have a wet dream's got to have, you know, it's got to produce something.
Yeah.
A woman could actually just have a sexy dream and have an orgasm.
Yeah, exactly. I have them,
they
like,
might grind. They might grind a little bit
a
on something.
It'd be nice. Huh? Three
I
times
them,
a
like,
week?
Two or three times a week, yeah.
Ooh.
Do you masturbate?
Yeah.
You
Oof.
Do. You
and masturbate. Two or three times.
Before you go to sleep, no. And you still have it?
Not no? before I go to sleep. I mean, I do like regularly.
Right. During the day?
I don't know. I mean, me and my boyfriend have sex regularly, and I get off then, too. So.
All right, baby doll.
Do you have multiple orgasms?
No.
No, okay. All right. Good times.
What are you doing?
Good times of living.
You working?
Yeah. I worked at a pool hall. I'm a waitress.
Nice.
Do you ever go to sleep there?
Huh?
Does he ever get
take
you
a nap in the back or something?
Does he ever nail you on a snooker table?
No. I just got a pool table, though, so we'll see.
You did? Oh, yeah. You got to christen it.
Yeah, exactly.
All right.
All right. Well,
ball
thank
in
you.
Hairy
play
pocket.
Some stick.
Yeah, good times, baby doll.
All right.
Once in a while, you get a chick who's 18, sounds like she's 33, 34. Like, that chick just sound like, she doesn't sound like an 18-year-old.
No, the pussy gets
pool. Yeah, as the trim gets tighter.
Yeah.
Wesley freaked himself out over here.
I think I freaked out.
He dropped the P word. I think we can say that.
Oh, okay.
But I don't think we should. I don't know. I'm not sure of the rules. We never seem to get in enough trouble for doing this show. Drew,
they're
quiet
pussies
over there. Drew.
What a bunch of pussies. Those Drew. Pussies.
All right. Oh, evidently, no. We can say it. Let's hear a song from Puddle of Mudd. How about that? You psyched, Drew?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you drink?
I was having coffee.
He was having a sip of Postum. Yeah, let me tell you something, Drew. Yeah. You and your low self-esteem over here. You know, we don't have milk for my coffee. You want to know why?
Because of me.
Because you like the powdered stuff. Why don't you put milk in your coffee like a man? How can you put powdered stuff? Drew prefers the powdered crap above the milk, and it's not like it tastes, you know, it's not like Irish cream or anything. It just says powdered stuff. It's whitener. It actually says whitener on the thing. It's generic white. It's like putting flour. It's like sprinkling flour on top of your coffee. He likes
milk.
It over milk.
It's nice.
Yeah, it's great for you, and now we don't have any milk. I blame you, Drew. Why can't you put milk in your coffee like a human being?
All right, I'll start.
Start doing it, would you?
Yeah, I'll start doing that.
Do you actually think the powdered crap tastes better, or is your self-esteem that low?
I can't explain it, really. It's not even about low self-esteem. It's about, I don't know, being on radio, and I don't know.
Just knock it off, would you? Because now I don't have any milk.
All right.
And then I'm the complainer. And Drew, he gets by on talc. What do you need milk for? Oh, your highness, you need milk. Drew just ate a, someone hawked a dried loogie into his coffee. He was happy as could be. Look at you, big prima donna. All right, Drew, let's hear something from Puddle of Mudd, yes?
Yes, please.
All right, this song is called Away From Me.
Sitting here by myself, and I
Puddle of Mudd for you. Wesley's here tonight representing. And the new CD, Life on Display, is out Tuesday, 1 week from tomorrow. Jon Stamos, the 26th Beach Boy, is on line 7, or so it says. We'll find out. Jon? Jon?
Hi, Adam.
Goes by the name. Jon Stamos?
Adam?
What's happening, my brother?
I just did your boy Jimmy's show.
That's right. He's good people, isn't he?
He's good and he's funny, but I wanted to talk to you because I haven't. I've been dying to do your show.
Really?
And talk about sex and such.
Because producer Ann has been dying to get you in here for ever since you were Blackie on Days of Our Lives.
Nobody asked me.
Nobody's asked you? Well, see, these are what publicists do, Jon. They get in between.
Well, you got your boy Lewis, who never, you know.
Oh, yeah. Is my publicist your publicist?
Yes.
You know, let me tell you how evil publicists are. They even keep their own clients away from each other.
Exactly.
They're that evil.
Is Dr. Drew there?
Yes, Jon.
Hi, Doctor.
Talk to Jon.
Hey, Jon, what's up?
Jimmy just jumped on.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Hi, Jimmy. What's happening?
Going on here, right?
We're having a party afterwards.
How'd the show go tonight?
The show went well.
Midgets.
Very well. We had a midget kiss band.
Freaked me out.
Nice.
And Jon actually is terrified of midgets.
Smart.
And the greatest thing is he's got a midget thing, you know, and I guess whatever the reverse of a fetish is. And
kryptonite.
At the end of the night, they were interviewing, they were sitting up on the bar, and one of the guys said, "Hey, who's going to help me down?" And he extended his, I wouldn't say hand, more of a paw.
Yeah.
He extended his paw, and Jon and I.
Jimmy was like, "Hey, help him down to make out with him."
And then we did that thing you do with kids where you take a 1, 2, 3, swing. We just kept doing it.
Yeah.
Were these dwarfs or midgets?
Dwarfs.
Is there?
Okay.
Here's the honest truth. I've had an issue with little people like the last 10 or 15 years. Everywhere I would go, like to Disneyland or to like anywhere in public, little people would kind of show up like at dinner, or like a family of little people, and people thought I was crazy. Like, you know, you know. And then my friends would go out with me and say, "Oh my God, you're right." But then I met Rebecca, and they kind of disappeared. So
she's very tall. They're afraid they'll get stomped.
No, but that's one of the reasons why I married her. A lot of people think it's all, you know, she's cool, but that was, you know, I couldn't talk about it in my vows. But
what garlic is to vampires, Rebecca is to midgets.
Kryptonite.
Wow.
Yeah.
That is.
But no, I'm kidding. These guys were great.
No, we don't like midgets. I'm with you. And
asshole.
Why should someone as physically perfect as you or Rebecca have to put up with anybody that's less than that?
It's not about looks.
I totally agree with Stamos. The beautiful people do not need to talk to the warts on the ass of society.
No. It's not about looks. It's about money.
You chill with the Olsen twins and the Beach Boys. You leave the midgets and the ugly people to me and Kimmel.
That's right.
We know how to handle them.
You know what freaked me out? When I met you, and I was so excited to meet you because I'm such a fan, your wife was like, told me that you watch Full House all the time.
Yes.
That's
constantly.
Weird.
You're gay.
I love Full House. It's good family entertainment. And I'm also was a big TGI Friday fan, too.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah,
Adam, like the Fred Savage's brother and everything, right?
Yeah. I'm, and I loved Full House. I loved you. You were a tough biker with a heart of gold, though.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. You really were. You loved those kids.
Thanks, Adam.
I'm sure you don't talk to any of the cast anymore, but I mean, on the show, you were fond of them, right?
When I need money, I talk to the twins.
Fantastic. Hey,
who
listen,
else is on the show tonight? I hear another voice.
Oh, Wesley's here from Puddle
of Mudd. Hey, what's up, Jon? How you doing, brother?
Hi, Wesley. Let's talk sex. That.
We can't.
Okay, sex. Go, sex.
We got to take a break. Can you guys hang on?
I'm going to let you on.
No, hell no. I can't hold on for sex.
We're interrupting Puddle of Mudd, though.
Oh.
Yeah, man. What's up?
I'm sorry, guys.
Are you in Jimmy's dressing room?
Yeah, it's great. Sarah's
is Rebecca,
here,
Rebecca over there. Oh, Sarah's over there.
Is here with her shirt off.
Jon, right,
there you go.
Listen, Jon, you guys. Hey, Jimmy, I think there's gonna be some swinging going on.
I really do. Out of his pants.
Favreau just walked in. He's naked.
All right, listen, Jon. Come in and talk to us in person as soon as you can.
I really would because I'm such a huge fan of the show. And I want to talk sex. I want to keep Rebecca off the show because she's a little loose-lipped.
Fine. We don't need any midget-hating troublemakers right. on this show. God bless you.
All right, Adam.
See you tomorrow.
See you, Dr.
John, I'll see you in...
oh, yeah, you like that?
What's that?
His meat cutting board.
All right, we got to take a quick break. We'll be right back.
Hello, this is your radio. LoveLine will be right back.
Music cues, I sues on views, I cues on views on cues.
What's up?
My kisser. My kisser, I see.
Yeah, it's all like
it's
what,
always
Drew?
Like Kizer. It's that's always right. Like my saying? Zoom, my this, zoom, my down. Zoom, zoom, Z.
Yeah. Wesley's here from Puddle of Mudd.
That's what I'm What's talking up, everybody?
About. Yeah.
Everybody get up. Come on.
Somebody here is calling, by the way, knows why Drew likes powdered milk over real milk.
Uh-oh.
Why?
We got to check that.
I don't know. They evidently know. Should we talk to them? It's going to be disappointing.
It's got to be scientific.
He's calling from Pasadena, which is your hometown, by the way.
Yeah.
Maybe he knows something about you. George?
Yes, sir?
You're 26. Why does Drew, other than low self-esteem, why does he prefer powdered creamer as opposed to milk in his coffee?
Well, actually, this is a scientific explanation here. Milk creates phlegm in the voice.
Mm. Oh.
Which, when you talk on a microphone, makes you sound kind of, you know, I don't know, you kind of get that whole
blah, 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 blah.
You know,
he's absolutely correct about that.
Oh,
dairy,
you know.
All dairy.
You're saying that
affects the vocal
right,
cords.
You know, right?
Yeah.
You can't drink a milkshake before you go out on stage.
No,
right?
No.
No, you can't. You're not even supposed to drink milk on a hot day because you know you'll poo cheese. So.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I like to poo cheese though.
Yeah, if it's good, if you can aim it just right so it lands on the cracker.
There you go. There you go.
You're in great shape. All right. So George's hypothesis is that Drew is such a pro, that's why he doesn't put the dairy products in his coffee. I would argue that if he was really that much a pro, he wouldn't sock the mic 3 or 4 times a night when he's moving around, whacking it every night at Zelba, talking to people off the microphone, saying things like thanks when people walk in and hand him stuff and then
Or how about taking the guest out of the hall and talking to him for 5 minutes when the show starts?
How about the other night when the show started and Drew was out chatting the guest up in the hall? Oh. Someone had to go get him. That is not the mark of a professional, my friend. So these all would poke gaping holes in George's professional idea. But a worthwhile try. And Drew, a supporter of Drew, obviously. All right. Wes, who do you want to talk to? You want to talk to someone about condoms, parents constantly fighting? Now, what about this guy's just been on hold for 79 minutes? Maybe we should talk to him.
Give him 1 minute to go. That should be good.
Yeah. Alex?
Yeah.
You're 17? Oh, sorry. Alex may be asleep.
Sleep. Yeah.
Oh, I hear him.
Yeah.
Let's go for number, let's go for the ex fiance left.
No, no, hold on.
All
we got to hear
all
Alex.
Right. We got to
there he is. There he
Alex.
Is. I hear him.
He's snoring.
Wake up! Oh, there he is.
What's up, dude?
What's
Get
happening,
up, dude?
Buddy?
Yeah. I'm
clear your throat, man.
You drink some.
You need some powdered milk.
You need powdered milk, buddy.
I've been having some problems with my family. My parents have been divorced. My parents have been divorced for 10 years.
Right. And we already answered the question. You were asleep.
Were you sleeping, man?
Almost.
Okay, well, wake up, brother.
Well, we gotta take a break
ask
now.
A question.
All right. So your parents are divorced.
Yeah, I know.
10 years.
Yeah, 10 years. My mom remarried, and so did my dad did also. And I'm going to homeschooling because I don't got enough credits to graduate.
Oh.
So I graduated and I was like 20.
Yeah.
And so they homeschool me so I can graduate in time with my friends and crap, I guess.
Yeah.
That's great. My mom and my dad, before they got divorced, they had a credit card.
Yeah.
And they both had their names on it. And then 10 years later, my mom told my dad and there's like $20,000 spent on it.
All right. Hold on a second, Alex.
Oh, boy.
Hold on. It's going to take more than just a couple of seconds to sort out. I like that, by the way. At the rate you're going, you would graduate high school at 26. But we'll homeschool you.
Yeah.
We'll give you a diploma in 3 weeks.
You're going to make it,
great,
bro. You're going to make it.
I'd like to do some home college and then some home work and then some home marriage. How about that? You know, just go home, get everything you need.
I think you should go back to sleep.
We'll take a quick break. We'll get back with Alex after this.
All right, guys, here's the deal. Looking to hook up?
Call the Dateline.
Sick of wasting time with the wrong person?
Call the Dateline.
One call's all you need to make.
Call the Dateline.
1-877-889-DATE.
You know what I'm saying out there?
Adam and Dr. Drew will be right back on Loveline.
Love Line, fast growing outlaw radio, North America.
Get down.
Getting down.
It's party time.
Drew's over there at Syracuse
representing.
Yeah. What's the lack over there, brother man?
3 degrees.
3 degrees. How the girls treating you over there, huh?
Oh, yeah.
A lot of fine ladies that part of the country.
Careful, man. He'll drop trowel. I'm telling you, he will do it. He'll do it. Watch out. He'll do it.
Drop trowel. Wes will drop trowel.
He's out of control.
We'll drop it. We're dropping it.
We'll drop it together.
Okay, we've dropped it.
The trowel's officially dropped. You say that, Drew.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Now I got a headache.
Back down to reality.
Everybody, Wesley's here from Puddle of Mudd.
What's up, everybody?
CD is coming out 1 week from tomorrow, and let me let you kiddies in on a little something-something that Puddle of Mudd is doing. One lucky person will have the opportunity to go out on tour with Puddle of Mudd on the tour bus, hang backstage, hang with the band. Is this for,
receive
this for 1 week?
Free guitars, free just all kinds of stuff. Get cash, party. It's going to be fun. It's going to be insane.
Now, here's how you do this. You buy the CD, and if the CD has the lucky prize in it, now what is it?
It's a platinum ticket.
Right.
And, you know, it's when you open the CD, it's going to just grab it, and, man, you call in, and, you know, you get your own tour bus.
Right.
Come hang out with us. Get, you know, we're gonna give some free guitars away. We're gonna sign a bunch of stuff. It's gonna be off the hook.
Now you guys will be on your tour.
Yeah,
and
they're gonna roll with us.
But they'll join you wherever you are on your tour. Is that how it works?
Yeah, they're gonna just fly out, get their own bus, and we're just trying to like give back to the fans, interact with the fans,
right,
and have a good time
and avoid people ripping the stuff off on the internet.
Yeah, definitely,
screw
man.
Them.
I mean, you know, when I was growing up, and I'm sure, you know, when you were growing up, you couldn't just kind of walk into a store and go, I'll take that, and roll out, you know?
Right.
So, and without consequences, you know?
Now, listen, we had 8-track cassettes.
Yeah, right.
Reel to reel. Drew would actually have to have the band in his car if he wanted music in his car. Drew,
of
back
course.
In the day.
Of course.
You'd throw him in the rumble seat, right?
Put
on your raccoon coat.
We didn't have these newfangled devices like an electric guitar.
Yeah,
right.
Guys just playing.
Hey, I'm still going old school with the acoustic guitar. You know, that's how they played most of my songs. So.
The recorders and things like that when I'm in the day.
They didn't have microphones either. Drew's bands would sing into one of those megaphone things.
Won't you be melancholy baby?
Right? Guy in a straw hat.
I used to record with a karaoke machine and switch the tapes back and forth.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Mix it that way?
It was a complete bitch.
You understand what we've been through, kids?
Total bitch.
All right. Let's... Now, who were we talking to? Oh, we were talking to Alex here. Yeah.
He's fighting. His parents are fighting.
Had some trouble. Alex?
Yeah.
All right. Parents have been divorced for 10 years.
Yep.
Credit card with both their names on it. $20,000 bill.
Yeah.
And
I go to school with my dad, where my stepmom actually teaches me. Oh. And now they're pissed and they want my mom to pay this money. And she just got recently divorced, so she's not financially steady or whatever.
Let me interject here, Alex. Your parents are, they're embarrassing disaster. That's fine.
Yeah.
You're going to homeschool. Forget about this homeschool. So what? You get a homeschool diploma. What do you do with that?
I don't know.
Parlay that into anything. You're not going to college. You need to start looking for a job, my friend.
I got one.
You do?
Yeah. What are you doing?
Cook.
All
right.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of cook?
I was actually going to go to a culinary school.
All right. Well, there you go. Listen, here's the advice.
You should probably pick up the guitar and release some inner demons, man.
Yeah, or spatula and release some entertainment.
And yeah, stop looking to the bong to release those demons.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's got to be tough to smoke weed when your stepmom is homeschooling you.
You should probably pick up some guitar or something, man, and, release some of that aggression you got inside of you, man, and probably come out pretty cool.
Do you play music? You interested in music, Alex?
Not really.
All right. Screw that, then. Look, it's not for everybody. Not everyone can be an artist, Wes. All right, Alex, here's what you need to do. You need to focus on your job. Don't worry about the homeschooling. Get a friend. Get a roommate.
Move out.
And leave all these troubles behind. Do not feel responsible for your parents and their woes and their screwed up relationships and lives. You just get your stuff, get your roommate, get out into the world, get on your own, and start finding your way.
Yeah.
And you may need to deal with that pot, seriously. Pay attention.
Smoking a lot of weed, Alex?
What? No, not really.
Not really.
Occasional.
Yeah.
Occasionally. All right. All right. What kind of cooking do you do? Short order cook?
Spanish food, part-time.
Oh, really? Because, yeah, he's calling from Minnesota. You want that good Mexican food, you go to Minnesota, my friend. No finer Mexican cuisine in the United States than Minnesota, am I right?
Of course. Further north you go, the better it gets.
Yeah.
It's head north for the border.
That's right. All right, buddy. Look, let me give my speech. Not everyone's a good student. I was a horrible student. I'm guessing Wes didn't make the dean's list.
I don't even know if I even knew who the dean was.
That's my point. But you were good at something, and you focused on it, and now you make a nice living doing it. And all you people like Alex who just, you're not good students, fine. You're not going to college. Great. You can make a good living as a chef. You go to culinary school. Go there for a couple years. Next thing you know, you're 19 years old, and you get a decent job at some four-star hotel.
I guess what we're saying here is that Adam Carolla is the poster child for not doing well in school and finding something you are good at and becoming literally a millionaire.
I'm literally a millionaire. I'm literally a millionaire. Yes, Drew?
Yes.
The cash is falling from the ceiling right now.
Literally. Literally, I'm a millionaire.
Whatever.
All right. Where are we here? Let's see. Who's been on hold
for
the second longest? Let's talk to Anthony. Been on hold for 82 minutes. I'm going to try to clear
82 minutes.
Hey, Anthony.
Hey.
Hey, you're 14?
Yeah.
What's up?
Okay, my question is, I've been having sex with my girlfriend, and she's also 14, and I want to know, if I could get in trouble, what are the statutory rape laws and stuff like
that? What state you calling from?
California.
Yeah, yes, you can get in trouble.
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Yes, you can.
Plus, that's kind of young, man, isn't it?
Not really.
That's pretty young, man.
Let's be clear. 14 is young. It is very young. Although for you, you may feel like you're ready, it's young. And for her,
you might want to move on to... 16, 17, I don't know, man.
Is it still
if you're 18, I mean, I guess that's
if it's
cool,
California, Drew, what is the law now? If it's California and you're both 14, it's illegal because the girl's under 14?
Under 16.
I mean, I'm sorry, under 16.
Right.
That's how it works?
In other words, I think the law is that they can be within 3 years of the woman as long as she is, if he's over 18.
If he's over 18?
Is it 18? Okay.
All right, Drew, you're obviously confused here.
It's 18. Wait a minute, that's
right.
It's a fine line.
Here's what I'm saying. If the chick is under 18 and you're under 18, it's better for you than you being over 18 and her being under 18.
Right.
But it still can be illegal.
Correct.
Okay. All right, so you've got to deal with that there, Anthony. What are you using for protection? What are you, a Pez dispenser? What do you use at 14?
She's on birth control.
All right.
At 14? Wow. Where'd she get it?
Planned Parenthood.
Fantastic.
Wow. All right.
Good for you guys. Well, there you go.
All right.
But Adam, I think you can be 17 as long as the guy is not over 20. And you can be 16 as long as the guy is not over 19.
Okay. Right.
The guy can be within 3 years of the girl if she's under 18.
Right. So
I think that's right.
But that doesn't work if the chick is 14 and you're 17, does it?
No.
Well, then what's the cutoff? 16?
Yeah, I believe.
Okay. Again, we do this show every night. People call from all over the country. They want to know the rules on statutory rape. Couldn't we just unify these rules? Does it have to be, well, in Hawaii it's 14, but in
Thailand
it's I don't know how much jurisdiction we have over other nations, but at least in the United States, couldn't we just call it 18 or 16 or whatever it is? Does it have to vary from Florida to Nevada to California? It's very confusing.
It's a union of independent states.
All right, but we agree on certain things. Like, we agree on the age to vote and the age to buy liquor, or at least we have recently come to agree on ages such as, voting, the military, things like that. How about just the age of consent? Just call it 17 in a month or something
Is such an unimportant
like controlling
thing.
The population or something.
Yeah, I just like the unified. That's all I'm saying.
I'm with you.
All right, let's talk.
The unified thing, yeah.
Talk to Andrew, been on hold for 94 minutes.
Adam, you got to get some calls here, dude.
Hey, buddy.
Come on
now. Andrew?
Yeah.
You're 20?
Yes.
You're calling from Missouri?
Yes, sir.
That's right. What's
right
up there, buddy?
Missouri.
Okay. I was with my ex-fiance for 4 years. Mm-hmm. She decides to up and leave me 2.5 weeks before we get married. We have a 7-month-old son together, and she's been like messing around with this other dude, and he's leaving for the military in January. Mm-hmm. And like lately she's been coming around a lot more than she has been in the past like month or so. Mm-hmm. And every time we're over here talking, she's like, this is kind of a bad situation. I'm like, why, you know? Mm-hmm. She says, because she'll end up doing something, and I'm just like wondering if I should even, try anything with her or what?
Well, let me ask you this. You have a 7-month-old. Did she leave your 7-month-old with you, or did she
she took him with her.
She took the boy with her.
And are you fathering the child at all?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You're in the child's life.
Yes.
So you guys have to have a relationship as parents anyway.
Yeah.
And what was the reason she gave you for leaving 2 weeks before your marriage?
The day she left, she just came home and, got her stuff and the baby and left. But the day before, we got into an argument about me writing up a will. I was like, and at the time, I was only 19. I was like, I'm 19 years old. My son's four months old.
Right.
I don't plan on dying anytime soon, you know?
And what, by the way, what are you leaving behind? A bong and a moped? You're 19, for the love of Christ.
Well, some Heely shoes.
I got a leather fanny pack, one Hirachi, a bong that was an apple at one point, and part of a toilet paper roll, and a moped. Oh, and a zipper scooter.
Well, now, see, I'm a little more established than most 20-year-olds.
Really?
I have three cars in my name, three cars that are paid for,
really?
My own house, and
house.
A couple, about $200,000 in the bank.
Holy crap.
What do you do for a living, man?
Yeah.
I build steel roof trusses.
Okay, and listen, screw her. I'm moving out there. We'll start fresh, brother. And I can build a truss myself, you know what I mean? I know the difference between a joist and a purlin. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but it's totally different.
Yeah, he's impressed, Adam. He's impressed.
Yeah.
All right.
You're doing good, man.
Yeah, I know the difference between a ridge rafter and a top plate.
She's confused for sure.
Yeah.
No, not really.
Okay, so what happened? Someone kick off and leave you all this stuff?
A couple Grinch grandparents went and left me money, so.
Yeah. It's all coming into focus now. What kind of wheels you got? What kind of car do you got?
Well, my daily driver's a 97 Cavalier. Little pooter car. But I got a 2000 Eclipse GST.
Ooh.
That's strictly set up for the drag strip.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then I've got my Montero.
All right. You're doing good. So, right, look, I don't trust this chick.
Yeah, she's dragging you into some chaos here.
Yeah, she's going, and, you know, she's coming back into his life. It's like...
Right. I don't trust her. She's going to be a very chaotic wife and mother. And then what will end up happening is you think, all right, well, we got a kid, and we were in love, and blah, blah, blah. Why do you have three kids, and she goes AWOL again 4 years from now?
Right.
Yeah, I mean, the reason I say anything is because the whole time we've been together, it's on it. We were together on and off.
Yeah.
And every time we broke up, it was because of her, and she never gave me a reason.
Well, I bet she comes from some chaos.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, she does.
Oh, yes. Serious chaos. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, like you know, abusive parents or alcohol parents or
both.
Whatever.
All of that.
Okay, so listen, Andrew.
Yeah.
You may know steel trusses, but I know the ladies, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You do the truss work, do you not?
Yeah.
Okay. Not impressed about the purlins of the ridge rafter talk, though, huh?
No, not really.
Okay.
It's because for him...
I know what it all is. I do it all day long.
All right, buddy.
Yeah. Right. Therefore, everyone must know what it is. See, Adam?
Do what's best for your kid, man.
Yeah. And for, screw her. Don't get back together with her.
Yeah.
All right?
All right.
You're an independently wealthy man. You got a couple hundred grand. Your grandparents left you. You got a nice house in Missouri, probably worth 18 grand. You got a sweet Cavalier to tool around in. You got yourself a Mitsubishi that'll run
Eclipse.
Under a... You got an Eclipse that'll run under a 12-second quarter mile. Probably got a nitrous... what's it run?
Nine.
Runs in the nines?
Yeah.
What, you got nitrous on that baby?
I got 136 grand under just the hood.
Yeah, see, that's a good father. 136 grand under
what?
The hood? What do you got into that engine?
It's import engine and anything and everything you can possibly think of.
You got the nitrous on there?
300 shots.
You got the turbo?
Yeah.
What kind of compression you running?
It's 8-1. Or 8.3 to 1.
Yeah, got to keep it low for the turbo.
Yeah.
How many pounds of boost you run on the turbo?
15.
Wow. All right. That's healthy. All right, buddy.
All right.
All right. I like guys who just pour every penny into their $4,000 Japanese car to shave another tenth of a second in the quarter mile. This is all. And believe me, when you know, he's got 100. What do you say? At 136 grand in there?
Yeah.
Now, that car's gone from $4,000 to $4,800 now. With bone stock.
I wonder what kind of movies
grand.
You own, man.
With the
what's your favorite movie, man?
With the Fast and Furious engine in it, it's worth another $800. You get one penny for every $7,000 you spend on that engine back.
So true.
All right, but
he might blow it up too in a race.
Oh, I'm sure he's blown many. Here's the deal. If you got a girl, and you don't know this when you're 20, well, you got a girl who comes from chaos. Her mom, maybe her dad was abusive, alcoholism, people beating on each other, chaos, okay? You get hooked up with that chick, you might have a couple of smooth months. Don't worry, there will be chaos, and it'll be a storm that blows in a couple times a year. She'll leave, it'll come to a head, she'll split, she'll go off some other guy, she'll be back 6 months later, everything will be smooth for a while. Then more chaos. It is a never ending chaos circle of S. Yes,
fest.
Drew?
Yes, chaos fest.
All right, he's got to and he's going to build them trusses. Not impressed of my truss knowledge though.
Isn't that weird?
Yeah,
the car knowledge was good, man.
I knew about the cars.
That was
I knew
awesome.
About the trusses.
But it's stuff that he knew. He knows it. Therefore, it's no big deal.
I'll bet you this. I bet he builds trusses for a living. I know more about trusses than he does. That's my commitment to you, Andrew, and the listeners. Let's hear something from Puddle of Mutt. That's what I think we should do.
Yeah,
we gotta play second song. You, how you doing there, Chris? You queued up? Feeling good? Get your hair cut? You looking good? Okay. Chloe, or you want to? You went to a place? You went to a prom? Oh, did you?
Yeah.
See, if I had hair like yours, I'd do the Flo-by. You got straight. You got good flowy hair.
Let's hear a song.
What's that?
Song? Yeah.
Puddle of Mudd. You want to do it when we come back? We can't play it right now before we go to break.
We're pretty late already.
All right. We're gonna take a. I'll let the baby have his bottle over there. Anderson got a rain on our parade.
How dare you?
Yeah. And interrupt my very important flowy jag I was having with engineer Chris. All right. We're gonna take a his favorite drop. We're gonna take a quick break. We'll come back. We'll hear a little something off the new Puddle of Mudd CD all after this.
Oh, yeah. Everybody now.
Yes, I will be right back in a minute.
Loveline will be right back.
Loveline, madam. That's Dr. Drew in Syracuse tonight.
Yahoo.
Yeah, that's deep, too, buddy.
Yeah.
He'll be back tomorrow night. Then
we're at our affiliate here in K-Rock.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's great.
Good people.
Great studios,
there.
Absolutely.
Really? Nice. Okay, quiet down now. Pink is going to be in here tomorrow night. No, Wednesday night. Then Thursday, Kathy Griffin and lots of good people. Rob Schneider, Blink-182, and Ron Livingston from, let's see, you know him.
Office Space.
What else? Anderson Swingers.
Sex in the City, not that I've ever seen
him. Sex in the City, yes, I've seen him on that. Swingers.
What does he play?
He's that dude.
He's Mr. one of the Big. Guys. No, he's got like 5 o'clock shadow. He's new.
Okay. You'll recognize him.
Great in Office Space.
When you see him. Yeah. And then, all sorts of big names rolling through here in the next few weeks.
Hey, Adam.
Yeah.
You got to hear what Drew was doing during the break. It's good stuff.
Yeah. Let's listen to it. Did you record it?
Come on.
That's right. Drew, come on. It's good. I got the good stuff.
What's he doing?
I don't know what he's doing. Anderson.
Forget it.
There's a piano in there. Oh, you can't hear it. Hold on.
Okay, hold on. I hear it. Drew playing the piano during the break.
There you go.
Oh, come on.
Drew, what is a piano? Are you in a Shakey's, Drew? Where are you? What's going on? They got a piano in the studio?
Yes. There's a guy that does AM morning shows here locally in Syracuse, and he plays the piano while he's doing his morning show. Isn't that funny?
I could dig that.
That's awesome, I think.
You know what I thought was one of the coolest jobs ever when I was growing up? Remember when you'd go to the mall, and there was a guy who played the organ out front of the mall? He just sat there in front of the organ store playing, you know, high yellow ribbon on the organ. And I just walk by that guy and go, wow, this guy's set for life, right? I mean, he's got it made. He's the king of the mall. First off, everyone bows to him. The guys at Hot Dog on a Stick, the Orange Julius guys, they all kiss his ass. And he's just out there, and it's sort of for everyone to hear. It's not just the people that are in front of the piano store. I mean, it echoes. The entire mall echoes with the sounds that come from that guy's 88s. That, true. I can see you getting into that.
That'd be me.
That piano sounded really out of tune, man.
Yes, it is.
What do you got in there, an upright?
It's a little old upright. It doesn't have a name on it.
Drew, like, get over there and play something.
It's called the Nameless.
What do you got? Can you do chopsticks? Yeah. What can you do, Drew? Yeah, do something. Do a little Scott Joplin for us or something. Really? Drew, what the hell?
Et cetera, et cetera.
No, Drew,
working it, man.
Drew, for 10 years, never seen him touch a piano. Drew, what else do you do, buddy? You speak French? Don't tell me you speak French.
No, mais non.
Drew, sing in French while you play the piano.
No,
okay.
Need to.
All right. I'll tell you what
let's hear a Puddle of Mudd song.
But you got talent. You know what I mean?
Yeah, thanks, buddy.
All right.
That's what you always told me.
Yeah, we got real
I think the
talent,
words we used, though. I think the, yeah. instead of talent, I think the words you used were boring, wooden.
No.
What were the other words?
Not when you're playing that Scott Joplin on the piano.
I see.
Okay, Drew, we're gonna hear something from Puddle of Mudd, and then later when we come back, you're gonna do the theme from the movie The Sting.
Of course.
Yeah?
No.
Huh?
No.
Okay. This is a new song off the new CD, which is coming out in, 1 week from tomorrow, the 25th. It's called Life on Display, and the song is called Heel Overhead.
Sorry for wasting time.
Good song. Life on Display is the name of the CD. It is out starting 1 week from tomorrow, and you may just get that platinum ticket, which allows you to go out on tour with the band. And you only know if you buy the CD and open it up.
I think there's actually 10 platinum tickets. What's you like that, Drew?
I got a platinum ticket.
Drew, quiet down now.
Right?
Where is your... What do you see? Is that Willy Wonka song?
Yes, right.
All right. Get on the piano and make with tickling of the keys, would you?
Enough.
All right. There you go.
Stop it. It sounds
like a pigeon landed on it.
It's a pianist.
That is a good song. And you know what's nice is... Wes is here from Puddle of Mudd, and
what's up?
He was enjoying the song because he's not heard it on the radio before. It's probably the first time you've heard it on the radio,
yeah.
And it's nice because a lot of times bands come in here and we end up playing their song that's 2 years old. They've heard it 1,000 times, and quite frankly, they're tired of it. So it's nice to see the enthusiasm.
No, man, it was really... I thought that was great. That was awesome, man.
Well, it was a good song, and so far, everything on the CD is great. So it's coming out again 1 week from tomorrow. All right, let's go back. Drew, guess what I did while the song was playing, besides bang my head?
You went pee.
No, I looked to see what calls I wanted to take next.
Ooh, wow. Yeah,
that's right.
Wow, you're a pro.
All business. I'm going to start with Terry over here, who's 19. Terry?
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, Terry, what's up?
Just married.
Yeah.
Calling from Alaska.
Yes.
Nice.
Damn, she's cold.
And, very much so.
You got a question about waiting to have sex?
No, I waited until I was married to have sex. Mm-hmm. And now I don't know what an orgasm feels like or what I'm supposed to do or anything. I'm completely in the dark.
How old are you now?
19.
And you have a boyfriend?
A husband.
Well, she's married.
Husband, I'm sorry.
Just got married.
And you don't know, he's not telling you what he likes, or what's the problem?
No, me.
I know, but what do you mean you're not...
He's fine. I just don't know how I'm supposed to have an orgasm or anything like that. I've never been...
Yeah, well, you need to just basically wait about 15 minutes and then fake it. That's what my ladies do.
You're going to have to probably start masturbating and trying to figure it out for yourself, and then telling him what it is you want, what you need.
Okay.
It's not going to happen during intercourse. You can forget about that
for now. Does he give you oral sex?
Has he tried it? Yeah, but
He must not be very good.
Not so good at the oral sex.
He's totally listening.
He's going to have to improve his oral sex technique, and you're going to have to help him if you want an orgasm.
I don't know how you couldn't be good at that, though.
It's
not that hard.
You know the problem
is? Pretty simple.
Let me tell you the problem with the young guys, and this guy's a young guy.
Yes, he's 20.
They push a little too hard. They try too hard. The thing about oral sex is a smooth, consistent pace. Yeah. Here's what you got to be like with oral sex. You got to be like, if you take a guy and you take him a mile off the coast, you drop him out in the middle of the ocean. If he starts flailing and flapping and kicking and making a fuss, he's never going to make it to shore. Yeah. He's going to drown. Best way, smooth, even stroke. Barely make a ripple as you're
slow
going through the water.
Down.
Nice and smooth, consistent, rhythmic. That's what guys get, they shove their face down there and they go sick.
Yeah.
They have a spaz.
Yeah, they like freak out. They're like, oh, man.
Yeah, they go nuts. And then the chick starts responding like she's not too comfortable. So they go double time.
Yeah.
And now you're in trouble.
Right.
Nice and smooth. Yes?
Because the lady's going to kind of flow into the whole system.
I think it's time to give my cat analogy.
Yes. Perfect.
Let's see. Man would like his penis treated like a 9-year-old treats a Labrador. You know what I mean? Just dive on and work it, man.
Yeah.
Just come here, by grabbing the ears, rustling it down, pulling the paws out, you know, flopping it down, then shoving the face in the
rustle
belly.
Rustle
that penis down. Now, you try, but a woman, she needs to be treated like a cat. You can't just go bounding across the living room and pounce on the cat. Goes right under the sofa or on top of the refrigerator. Cat, you put that hand out. Cat will come by, sniff around. Cat will rub on it a little bit, put a little pressure on it. Cat will create its own pressure, just like the vagina will. Put a little pressure on the vagina. If it feels good, it'll push back a little bit. If you feel it pushing back, that's a good sign. If you feel it pulling away, that's a bad sign. But smooth, even strokes. Like, you want that cat to stay on your lap. You don't start grabbing on it and twisting its ears and going at it from every direction. Smooth, consistent, even strokes.
Just a little loving.
That's right. And the cat, when it starts finding something it really likes, it'll start pushing, start leaning, start rising a little bit.
Show you that part.
That's right.
Then you got it down.
Then it's TV time.
It's football time.
Yeah, you get to the TiVo. That's the final destination, fellas. All right, so as a woman, as a cat, don't be scared to tell that 9-year-old that's treating you like the Labrador, hey, slow it down a little, Sparky.
Yeah.
Just nice and smooth, nice and even. All right. We have a Germany or Florida here, Drew.
Yay.
Yeah?
Oh, good.
Yeah. All right, this is... Oh, good. Big theme song. Hold on.
Florida.
Now, be prepared to be underwhelmed because it's a 14-year-old Zach. Zach?
A 6-year-old boy has been torn to death by 2 fighting dogs in school. Mm-hmm. 2 other children are reported to have been hurt by the rampaging dogs, a pit bull and a Stafford Terrier. The boy, who was in Turkish origin, died of his injuries soon after the dogs attacked him.
Mm-hmm.
The schoolyard playground where the children were taking part in games lesson.
Mm-hmm.
These officers who rushed to the scene shot the dogs and killed them.
We would have heard. Yeah. Well, first of all, Florida, they wouldn't shoot the dogs.
No, they give the dogs the key to the city in Florida.
Right.
If you kill someone under 10, you're considered royalty in Florida as a dog. All right. Yes. And they also they like their dogs over there in Germany.
Yeah.
And the Turkish descent, that could be a German thing, but it could also just be a push because Lord knows, you know, Florida's just a mixed bag of crayons. You never know what you're going to get over there ethnically. We say in Germany here?
I'd say Germany.
Yeah.
Wes says Germany. We all go Germany. Germany, Zach.
Right. German Shepherd.
Are we right?
Yeah.
Thank you. All right. We're really 17 out of 18 in the Germany or Florida. Yes, Drew?
Yes.
All right.
We're fantastic at this.
Let's hop to the phones. And to be fair to us, they usually slip up and work in Deutschmark or Goose Step or something, and it keys us. Jared, you're 14?
Yeah.
Oh, really? Did I want to talk to you? Why do guys take longer? Wait, why does it take longer for girls to orgasm than guys?
Yeah.
Because? Yeah.
Because that's the way God made it.
Right.
Because they're cats.
Yeah, why do women live longer than guys?
They do.
Uh-oh.
Most of them do.
Jared, you got it. Yeah, not every one of them. Once in a while, one buys it on a motorcycle or something, but by and large, they live like 7-8 years longer than guys.
Why do you have that
to look forward to, Jared. Well, here's the trade-off. You get to have 4 or 5 orgasms for every one the chick has. On the other hand, you're in the ground 10 years earlier. You know what I mean? It's a fair trade. I take my life. I'll take my multi-orgasmic, my life where I leave a trail of semen right to the grave.
A little bit of your chi leaks out with every orgasm, and that shortens your life, see?
Maybe that's it.
That's it right there.
Just a couple cc's of your soul is spilt into the hamper each day. That may be true, Drew.
Yeah, of course. Of course.
I'm backing off. I'm now backed off. I'm now 3 times a day. All right, good times. Drew, you hop on that piano and
I haven't touched a piano in like 5 years. I ain't going to play on national radio.
Well, why don't you work up a little something for us?
Yeah,
we'll hear it, all right?
Yeah, right, yeah.
All right, please.
Good time.
Please
good
entertain
times.
Us.
Yeah, good time.
Do a little Puddle of Mudd when we come back, all right? All right, we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back.
LoveLine. We'll be right back.
Hey, everybody.
Woo-ha!
Love. Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Wes from Puddle of Mudd. And then Dr. Drew's out in Syracuse tonight. Drew?
Yeah.
You work up a number for us on the piano?
No.
Okay.
No, really.
No, that's cool. All right. Let's talk to Holly, who comes from chaos and disagrees with my synopsis about chaotic women.
Hello?
Come from chaos.
Hey.
Yes. What's up, Holly?
I have a bone to pick with you, Adam.
Go right ahead.
Okay. A while, I think it was like two calls ago, you said that if a girl comes from chaos, I think you should run from them.
Yeah.
Is that what you said? Something like that?
Probably.
Well,
yes.
For the 14-year-old calling.
For the
guy was 20. He was 20, but.
Okay. But maybe for a little bit older age bracket, because I'm 25 and I come from a lot of chaos and I work very hard to maintain a healthy adulthood. And
excellent.
If I were to ever have kids, that I wouldn't pass it on. And to any other little girl right there that's maybe listening that is going through chaos, you can get out of it, like even mentally. It just takes a lot more work than other people.
Right, well, look, here's the whole thing about the chaos survivors, which is really just sort of trauma survivors.
Yeah.
It's like the person who gains weight easily and has a slow metabolism. If you got somebody who says, hey, screw it, I'm just going to eat Carney's dogs all day long, then you're going to be married to a morbidly obese person and dies of diabetes when they're 39. But if you got somebody who realizes there's a problem here, exercises, eats right, works hard at it, then you have a better person maybe than you would have had.
Right.
So, Holly, yeah, you can be, if you have someone that comes from chaos and they go, okay, I'm going to get some therapy, I'm going to get some counseling, I'm going to really work on my problems, I'm going to be very conscious not to do this kind of stuff in front of my kids and to my partner and all that, then you probably have a person that may even be better than somebody who never had any chaos and didn't work on anything. Although, if there was real, you know...
Yeah, it depends how bad, yeah.
Serious abuse, it is tough.
Yeah, I
understand that. And I'm glad that we've come to a common understanding now.
Yeah, well, listen, screwball, if you listen...
The bone has been picked.
If you listen to this show with any regularity, you'll hear that all the time.
I do, but that just kind of slipped a little bit. I don't listen to it regularly, but...
All right, well, that's your problem, sister.
I'm sorry,
okay? Listen more.
But, yeah. You know, I just wanted to hear it from you. Thank you.
All right, thanks for calling.
And you know what? I'm probably one of the very few girls that thinks that you're actually hotter than Dr. Durrell.
Wait a minute.
Was there a compliment in there somewhere? That's good. I like that.
Okay, so.
Adam, tell her about the girl that told her friends that she was crazy for picking you. Remember that?
Yeah, this all started when I was 14 and Esther Chilodenko called up and said, you know, it's between you and your friend Chris to see who's going to get to be my boyfriend. And Adam, I picked you. All my friends think I'm crazy, but I picked you. And I thought, wow, that's nice. That's people don't realize, you know, I went into the masonry supply store today, and the guy behind the counter is like, hey, man, I was listening to you making fun of them short valet parkers the other night, and I was laughing my ass off. And I don't normally laugh that much. I mean, I listen to the show, and I don't normally laugh that often when I'm listening to the show. But the other night with them valet parkers, man, that was some hysterical stuff, man, because I've heard the show and you know it's not very funny. Yeah, but the other night, man, and it's like you realize, like, I eventually said to the guy, hey, enough with the compliments, you're killing my self-esteem.
I think it boils down to, like, beauty is skin deep.
That's right. I'm beautiful on the... wait a minute, that sounded like more of the same, didn't it, Drew?
Yes.
Yeah. That's more abuse coming from the beautiful Wes over here. It's easy for you blonde Adonises to sit there and talk about inner beauty when you have no problems on the outside. But where do you get that nappy hair and those big teeth? All right.
Hold on, man.
No, Wes, okay. You're into me, right?
Yeah, you're badass,
there's
man.
Nothing wrong with me. All right, Drew.
Yeah, you're badass.
Let's get one more. Why don't you ever call me badass,
I love that. From now on, I'm going to.
All right. And Nayab?
Yeah, hi, Adam. Hi, Drew. Hey. Hi, Puddle of Mudd.
Hey, what's up, brother?
You're calling from the United Kingdom?
Right on.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Simon, we work shifts and we like to listen to you because we think you're the funniest.
How do you listen to us in the UK?
Internet radio.
Oh, really?
Wow, that's interesting.
We love it.
I've tried to bring Loveline over to the UK. I was over there last summer. I was trying to get something going over there.
It would be bigger than Jerry Springer because it's more intelligent.
God bless you. See, everyone.
Adam, your politics would work here.
It would, huh?
Yeah.
That's fascinating.
Well, thank you. And what the hell kind of name is NAAB?
My parents are from Pakistan.
Holy Christ. Tell you, that English accent will screw you up.
I was born here.
Guy, an Indian guy, they all got that English accent.
No, not all right.
Would you like me to talk like this?
Yes, that would be much more
maybe
entertaining.
Maybe she's a bit more talented.
Oh, my God.
No, so not all right.
Where do you work over there, NAAB?
I can't say because I'm using the boss's phone.
I understand. And now what time is it over there?
It is
noon.
Up to 10 to 8.
10 to 8. All right, yeah. Shut up, Drew. What do you know from noon?
It's 5 in the afternoon.
It's 10 to 8 in the morning, yes?
Yes, sir.
All right, so you can work. It's your job in the United Kingdom. And hold on, kiddies. That's England. Oh. You understand? A lot of
you know why I screwed that up? I'm 3 hours later here in the East Coast.
It's 4:20 where Drew is. Yeah.
That's right.
You know, England, that tiny little cat fart of an island just off the coast of Europe.
Yes, most are callers.
The U.S.'s biggest aircraft carrier.
They
nice.
By the way, Drew, it would still be 11 o'clock over there if that what you say is true.
But no, it's 5 hours later. It's 8 hours from where you are.
Yeah. All right, quiet down. All right, so NAAB.
Yeah, you have a question.
Yes.
All right.
Is there a reference hobo power? Okay, yeah, you know your scale is 1 to 50.
Yeah. No, it's 100. Yeah, right. 100 is...
Is it 1 to 100? I'm
sorry. No, 100 is like absolute zero. It's a theoretic. It doesn't really exist in nature, but it could. The universe would come to an end if we actually reach 100 hobo power.
Yeah, now let me explain hobo power very quickly. It is a unit to measure stink. We don't have one. We have kilowatts and BTUs. Ooh, British thermal units. We can measure almost anything except for stink. So I've come up with hobo power, and here's how it is. So when you go, like, I was on an elevator with this cat that was at, like, 9 hobo power, everyone can go, wow, that's pretty serious, instead of, this guy reeked. You see what I'm saying? So, yeah. Drew, what is vomiting? Is 50?
50, yeah, 50, you vomit.
You get to 50 hobo power, you vomit. And 100, again, is just theoretical. Doesn't necessarily exist. No one has ever seen 100, or at least lived to tell about it. All right, we got to take a break. NAAB, God bless you for calling from all the way over there in the
that's amazing.
UK. Yeah, give us a call anytime, and we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back.
Okay, so I know there's nothing wrong with me. So what's up?
So I was like you, and I used to think that these datelines were totally cheesy.
Why can't I meet anybody?
But I tried everything else and thought, what the hell? So I called the dateline and actually met a cool guy.
I called the dateline and I hooked up with some cool people.
Believe it or not, other normal people are out there looking too.
877-889-DATE.
1-800-LOVE-191. We'll be right back.
The show, everybody. Drew.
Yeah.
Drew.
You go back to that hotel, you get some rest, but give me a call on my cell, buddy.
Okay, of course.
Yeah, we'll get our talk on.
Yeah.
That's
what I'm talking about.
Wesley.
Wesley, good to talk
to you. Thanks a lot, you guys. Thank you so much.
Puddle of Mudd, everybody. New CD coming out.
Life on Display, 25th.
1 week from tomorrow. Go out and get it. Get that platinum ticket and go on tour with the band. God bless you. Pink in here Wednesday. Kathy Griffin Thursday. And until next time, it's Adam Kroll for Dr. Drew saying mahalo.
Sponsors for this station. The producer for Loveline is Ann Ingold. Loveline is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.